Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are new to my channel, my name is Lynn. I'm a medical scientist. I'm doing research about aging and cardiovascular diseases. In today's video, I'm going to talk about how to write a literature review in 10 days. Throughout my career, I have published 80 scientific papers. Among them, as first author, I have published 15. And as corresponding author, I have published 7. Writing a literature review is very important, especially before we start a new research project or before we go deeper exploration into certain research topic. For the past 3 months, I have been experimenting how to write a literature review more efficient. Here is what I have learned. I'm going to break down the writing literature review process into 7 steps. I found these steps are easily workable and very efficient. Step 1 is choosing the research topic. It can be a particular disease, particular drug, or a particular research method. Usually, your PI or your mentor will give you a clear idea about it. If you are a graduate student or if you are a PhD student, I suggest you to choose your review topic about the project that your thesis or your graduate work is going to be about. Step 2 is the literature search. This is the most important step. In this literature search stage, we are trying to answer 3 important questions. The first question is, what have been done? What are the research that have been reported in that particular topic? What are their findings? What are their conclusions? And the second question is, what hasn't been done? What are the critical issues that hasn't been answered? And the third question is, what are the limitations? What may get limited to answer these questions? What are the technological advancements that need to improve in that particular area? During this literature search stage, I suggest you to have 5 to 10 most relevant reference papers for your review, because this will save you a lot of time when you do the actual writing. Step 3 is choosing the journal that your review manuscript finally will be submitted. Usually, many people write first and then choose the journal later, but I found that choosing a journal before you start writing is very efficient, because by choosing the journal first, you will have a clear idea about your review manuscript format in terms of total word count, in terms of the number of title and subtitle that you can use, and then the total number of figures and table that you can construct. Step 4 is structuring your review content. In this step, we are going to brainstorm title and subtitle that we are going to use in our manuscript. Earlier, I have mentioned you to have a 5 to 10 most relevant reference paper during your literature search stage. So in these steps, you can use those paper as a reference to construct your title and subtitles. Step 5 is collecting data and filling the contents. So in this step, you have the title and subtitle already, so you're gonna fill in the information under those title and subtitle, the most relevant data, the most relevant content. Step 6 is the actual writing. Now we have collecting all the information, we have the title and subtitle, and this step, you need to do the actual writing. Step 7 is editing, polishing, and proofreading. In this step, I suggest you to collaborate with your colleague, because sometimes we can automatically understand our manuscript, but if your colleague found it not easily understandable or confusing, you better fix that part, because your major audience of readership cannot understand that part as well. It's very likely. When you are writing your manuscript continuously, you miss a lot of typo, but other people can spot it out very easily. So it is very efficient to let your colleague check your paper. Now we understand step 1 to step 7 of writing the review. We're gonna allocate the time. We wanted to complete it within 10 days. So step 1 to 3, choosing the topic, doing the literature search, and then finding the journal for your final submission. This can take 1 to 3 days. And then step 4, structuring your review content. This can take approximately 1 day. And then step 5, collecting and filling the data. That can be 1 day. And then the actual writing can be 4 to 5 days. Then editing and proofreading is 1 day. So voila, in 10 days, you can get a draft of your review manuscript. Alright, I hope you will be able to write your review paper, and good luck for that. If you wanted to check all the paper that I have published, I put the link in the description. You can check it out. Also, if you want to watch how I write my review paper, and I'm gonna upload a video very soon, stay tuned for that. Finally, stay happy, stay fit, and stay safe. Love you guys. Bye-bye.